Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs, and I welcome you all in this video of Morning Things. As you guys know that the questions that I discuss in the morning days are useful for your RBSEBI Nawari examination. But in addition to those examinations, the questions that I take up in these videos are useful for your banking PO examinations as well. So on that note, let's begin this video. And the students who have not subscribed to our channel, guys, please subscribe and hit the bell notification. It is for your own good only, because the new uploads that we make on our channel can be notified to you instantly if you have subscribed and hit the bell notification. This is the Telegram group where you can directly ask your queries to your mentors and also enjoy the free quizzes. The link of this group is in the description below. This is the new course for 2022, guys. Here we provide you with PDFs, videos and mocks. Apart from this, you will also get the assistance for your interviews, final interviews, by the way of mock interviews. So we conduct mock interviews so that you can be prepared for your final interviews. This booklet you will get once you enroll in this course, and here we have 30% discount on this course, which you can avail by using RBI50 coupon code. This is the number which you can dial if you have any query related to the examination. So that was all. Now let's begin the first question of current affairs. How much assistance will be provided to the selected startups at the SAGE initiative of the government? Now, SAGE has a full form, Senior Care Aging Growth Engine. Now, what does this mean? What is the purpose and what are the details of this initiative? That we will discuss a little later. But let me first tell you the answer of this question. So, the right answer here is option A, rupees 1 crore. So, all these startups that are going to be selected under this SAGE initiative will get rupees 1 crore as assistance from the government. Now let's discuss what is the purpose of this initiative, why would these startups be selected under this initiative, or what would be their responsibility if they get selected into this initiative. Now first of all, let me tell you that the SAGE, the full form of this SAGE, clearly indicates that the purpose is targeting the elder population, the older population of India. So that is very obvious thing. Now the second thing that you should remember here is that the SAGE initiative was not launched alone. It was launched along with the portal. So we also have a portal named SAGE. Now, what is the purpose of this portal? Basically, the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment has launched this SAGE initiative and SAGE portal. On this SAGE portal, the elder population of India will get access to all the services that they would need to survive in this world. Like from the healthcare sector to insurance to loans to financing to everything in the world that would be required by the elder population, they will get one-stop access at the SAGE portal. Okay, so I hope that this much is clear to you. Now guys, these services will be provided by the startups on this portal. So these startups are going to provide the services or the innovative products on this portal, and this portal is going to serve the elder population of India. Now remember that the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment is going to be the facilitator on this portal. Now what does this mean by becoming the facilitator of this portal? The facilitator refers to providing the guidance to the elder people so that they can access the services provided by the startups on this portal. So that much is clear to you guys. Now here, this portal is clearly serving two purposes. First is to help the elder population of India, and second is to provide the entrepreneurship opportunities to these startups so that they can grow up and build innovative solutions for the elder population. Now why is so much focus being laid upon the elder population of India? The reason behind this is the rise in the number of that population. You know guys that in the year 2001, 7.5% of the total population of India was elders, and this is expected to increase to 12.5% by the year 2026, and it is going to surpass 19.5% by the year 2050. So this is a huge percentage, a huge proportion of the population is going to be dominated by the older people. That is why the government of India is laying so much focus on the silver economy. Now, what is this silver economy? This term is important for you. Now, let us discuss the details of this initiative so that you can understand the meaning of silver economy as well. So, this point, guys, we have discussed it, that the SAGE portal is going to provide services across health, housing, care centers, technological access linked to finances, food and health, wealth management, legal guidance on this one portal. So this is covering a vast dimension. The next point here is that startups will provide the services on this portal and ministry will be the facilitator. The next point here is important, that the independent screening committee will be set up and that committee will choose the startups that are going to be eligible under this initiative. And those startups will get rupees 1 crore as one-time equity investment from the government so that they can develop innovative solutions and provide on this portal. So that was all about this one slide. Now moving on to the next slide, where we have this point, which is important. The Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment has disclosed that the government, the central government, has set aside rupees 100 crore for the promotion of silver economy. So what is this silver economy? Briefly, the silver economy is the economy that is driven by the needs of elder population. As you would know that 19.5% of the population, or I would say that over 19.5% of the population is going to be elderly population. So if the government is keeping the long-term goal in its mind, then this silver economy is basically in order to help the older people and achieve the economic development. The government is laying so much focus upon the silver economy. So that was the brief introduction of silver economy. Silver is basically the color synonymous to white, and the white hair, the gray hair basically. So from here you can remember that silver economy focuses upon the elder people. Okay. Now that was the brief introduction of this silver economy. Your task is to completely understand the dimensions of the silver economy. Why I am saying this thing? Because in your phase 2, in ESI particularly, you might get a question, descriptive question particularly for the silver economy. So do prepare this topic comprehensively. And in case you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. Okay, the next point here is that this SAGE program has been launched on the initiative or on the recommendation of this Empowered Committee on Startups for the Elderly. This point is very important, that rupees 25 crores has been set aside for this initiative for the current year. So that was all about the SAGE initiative. I hope that it is clear to you guys. I have one more thing to discuss with you, and that thing is the SAGE group that was set up by the central government back in the month of January this year. So this SAGE group stands for South Asia Group on Energy. Remember that this is a group set up under the Ministry of External Affairs, and SAGE is the initiative launched by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. So these two things are clearly different, guys. Do not mix them up. Okay. So from the full form, it will help you memorize it better and memorize the difference between these two. On that note, I would like to ask a question from you, and that question is the chairperson of the SAGE group, because at the time when this group was created, the central government clearly announced the person that is going to be the chairperson of this SAGE group. So here your task is to tell me the name of that person. Moving on to the next question. Recently, Indian Navy has decommissioned INS Sandhyak after 40 years of its service at Naval Dockyard in Vishakhapatnam. What kind of ship INS Sandhyak is? Container, offshore tanker, bulk carrier, or hydrographic survey ship? Out of these five options, this one is the right answer. So remember that INS Sandhyak is the oldest hydrographic survey ship of Indian Navy that has been decommissioned recently. That was all about this information. There is nothing much that we can discuss. Who is the MD and CEO of RBL Bank? So out of these five options, Rudishwarveer Ahuja. Option D is the right answer. Many of you would know the answer already, because this is the reappointment. Rudishwarveer Ahuja was already there as the MD and CEO of RBL Bank, and recently his reappointment as the same person as the MD and CEO of RBL Bank has been approved by RBL. Therefore, it is in the news. Your task is to tell me the tagline of this bank in the comment section below. Next is, who has been elected to the board of International Dairy Federation from India? So out of the five options that you are seeing on your screen, the right answer is R.S. Sodhi. He is at present the MD of Gujarat Cooperative Milk Marketing Federation. This is the organization that is manufacturing the Amul brand of products. So basically the products under Amul brand are being developed by this Gujarat Cooperative of Milk Marketing Federation. So that was about R.S. Sodhi. Now let us learn something about this International Dairy Federation as well. First of all, the very first fact that you should remember is the World Milk Day, because on this day only this appointment was approved. So World Milk Day is observed on June 1st, and the theme for this year was sustainability in the dairy sector. Now this theme also focuses on empowering the environment, nutrition and social economies. So this is one major fact that you should not forget. Okay, the next fact here is that is basically about the structure of IDF. So let me tell you that each and every country is represented by its national committee in the IDF, in the International Dairy Federation. So India is represented by Indian National Committee, INC. It's not Indian National Congress, so do not get confused whenever you see INC IDF in its short form. Okay, INC stands for Indian National Committee. The second point of importance here is that the Secretary of Union Ministry of Fisheries and Animal Husbandry and Bearing serves as the President of this INC, that is Indian National Committee. And right now we have Atul Chaturvedi as the serving Secretary of this ministry. The next point here is that National Dairy Development Board serves as the Secretariat of this Indian National Committee at IDF. Okay, and the current chairperson of this NDDB is Varsha Joshi. This is a very basic fact that India is the world's largest producer of milk. Now we have discussed everything related to India, okay, at IDF. Now there are some facts that we should lay our focus on if we are talking about International Dairy Federation. So the first fact here is the headquarters of this federation. Where is this federation located? So it is located in Brussels, Belgium. And it was established back in the year 1903. So these were the two facts. The third fact related to this federation is its president, that I am leaving on to you guys, that you have to tell me in the comment section. Next question is about the Environment Day. So which country is the global host of World Environment Day 2021? Leave aside the host. First tell me that when is this day observed? So the day is observed on June 5. I am telling this the answer of this question so that the people who don't know would know the answer. Okay. So Spain, India, Pakistan, Nepal, Vietnam are in the options. Out of these five options, Pakistan is the right answer. So Pakistan is the global host for this year. Now, what is the theme of World Environment Day for this year? The theme is reimagine, recreate, and restore. Now, guys, let me clarify this point to you that some websites like Business Standard has mentioned ecosystem restoration as the theme of this day, but that is not the theme because I have myself checked it from the United Nations website that reimagine, recreate and restore is the theme for 2021 and ecosystem restoration is the basic focus of this year's day. So remember that ecosystem restoration is not the theme but the focus of World Environment Day 2021, and Pakistan is going to host the global celebrations for this day by keeping ecosystem restoration as the focus of the event. So I hope that I am clear to you. Reimagine, recreate and restore is the theme and ecosystem restoration is the focus. Now let us discuss some facts related to this day. Pakistan is going to host the global celebrations and ecosystem restoration is the focus. Now, United Nations Decade on Ecosystem Restoration is going to be celebrated from 2021 to 2030. This is important, okay? The next point here is that why do we celebrate this day on June 5? The reason behind this is that on June 5, 1972, there was United Nations Conference on the Environment. And guys, this was the first time that a major conference was held on the theme of environment in Stockholm. So remember that this is why June 5 is celebrated as the World Environment Day. Now let's see what are the events that India organized on this day. So Ministry of Petroleum in addition to Ministry of Environment jointly organized an event on the theme of promotion of biofuels for a better environment. So guys, biofuels is one emerging area where India is laying its focus. So remember the theme as well. Now, Films Division of India organized a two-day online festival, Oasis of Hope, to mark this World Environment. This is again an important point. Oasis of Hope was organized by which institution on World Environment Day 2021? This can be a probable question for your upcoming examination. So do not leave out this point. So guys, that was all for today. I hope that you have enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching.